Hey, how's it going, everybody? Good times are ahead. Ain't that right? Vanessa, good stuff on your Bible verse that you sent me. I'd heard Jim Brown say it, been meaning to get to it, and I finally put it on Facebook because I wanted to put it on Facebook with the other verse that you also knew. So it's super cool. God knowing us while we were in the womb, of course, means he knew us like Ephesians 1, 4, and 5, from before the foundation of the world, for whom he did foreknow. So it's all just very, perfect, I think is the way to say it. Just the way God's word matches up, Old Testament, New Covenant, Old Covenant, which is Testament. It's fascinating. All right, looks like we had a clean break. Starting a new chapter. Luke chapter 6, verses 1 through 9. Okay. Let's get started. It's Luke first. What am I doing? Okay. Because the books are switched. Daniel now starts before Luke in the book. So my brain was hardwired there. And it came to pass on the second Sabbath, after the first, that he went through the cornfields, and his disciples plucked the ears of corn and did eat, rubbing them in their hands. And certain of the Pharisees, which means a group of the Pharisees, said unto them, "Why do ye that which is not lawful do on the Sabbath day?" And hang on just a quick second. All right. And Jesus answering them said, "Have you not read so much of this, what David did when himself was an hungered, and they which were with him? And how he went into the house of God and did take and eat of the showbread, and gave also to them which were with him, which is not lawful to eat, but for the priest alone. And he said unto them, that the Son of Man is Lord also of the Sabbath." This is a very key Bible verse because there's no ritual keeping of any holy day anymore. You do not have to keep any holy days or any new moons or it's Colossians, but I can't. Yeah, it's 2:16. Let no man judge you by eat or drink. Let no man judge you in meat. So it doesn't matter what you eat anymore. If it's pork or shellfish, is it healthy for you? No. So all of that was about health and cleanliness and rituals and so forth. Or in drink. Can you get drunk? Nope. Those which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom. Drunkenness is one of them. He'll call you out of getting deep into that spirit world if you're his. In respect of an holy day, so keeping the Sabbath as a ritual, Jesus is now Lord of the Sabbath. Our rest is in Jesus, or of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days. So all of that, holy day, Sabbath days, none of that does a sheep have to keep. I would tell you, stay clear away from that stuff because it'll bog down your mind. Just stay in the truth of what the Word of God says. And he said unto them that the Son of Man is Lord also of the Sabbath, because he is our Sabbath rest. What did Jesus mean when he said he is our Sabbath rest, Bible verse? He didn't say it. Paul said it. It's in Hebrews. How is Jesus our Sabbath rest? He said he is Lord of the Sabbath, and I got confused again. Hang on, I'll find it for you. Well, it's Hebrews 4, 9 through 11. Therefore remaineth therefore a rest to the people of God. For he that is entered into his rest, in other words, a sheep, when you get that call, he also have ceased from his own works as God did from his. You know, that seventh day. Let us labor, therefore, to enter into that rest in Jesus, lest any man fall after the same example of unbelief. Very good, then. Sorry, that's from my other channel. Where did we go? Oh, we're still in Luke. And it came to pass also on another Sabbath that he entered into the synagogue and taught. And there was a man whose right hand was withered. And the scribes and the Pharisees watched him, whether he would heal on the Sabbath day, that they might find an accusation against him. But he knew their thoughts and said to the man which had the withered hand, "Rise up, stand forth in the midst." And he arose and stood forth. And Jesus said unto them, "I will ask you one thing. Is it lawful on the Sabbath days to do good or to do evil, to save life or destroy it?" We'll get to the rest of that tomorrow. Continuing on in Daniel 1. Then said Daniel to Melzar, whom the prince of the eunuchs had set over Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, "Prove thy servants, I beseech thee, 10 days, and let them give us pulse to eat and water to drink." The pulse was like beans. "Then let our countenances be looked upon before thee, and the countenance of the children that eat the portion of the king's meat. And as thou seest, deal with thy servants." So he says, let us eat what we want for 10 days and compare us to the others who are eating the king's training table meal. So he consented to them in the matter and proved them 10 days. At the end of the 10 days, their countenances appeared fairer and fatter in flesh than all the children which did eat the portion of the king's meat. Then Melzar took away the portion of their meat and the wine that they should drink and gave them pulse. As for these 4 children, God gave them knowledge and skill and learning and wisdom, and Daniel had understanding in all visions and dreams. Now, at the end of the days that the king had said he should bring them in, then the prince of the eunuchs brought them in before Nebuchadnezzar, and the king communed with them, and among them was found none like Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Therefore stood they before the king. We'll get to the rest of that tomorrow also. Love you very much. Ask questions anytime. That's what I'm here for.